Chaotic scenes inside a packed city council meeting, mostly thanks to Toronto Mayor Rob Ford and his brother Doug, a city councillor. At one point, as Mayor Ford rushed to help his brother handle hecklers, it almost turned violent. City Council was making its latest move to restrict Mayor Ford's authority. He's lately admitted smoking crack cocaine, buying narcotics, and drunk driving. He's also made lewd and offensive remarks. That's why councillors say they're restricting his powers. To his brother, it's nothing less than a coup d'etat.
This is a slippery slope for democracy, not only now, for the next 10 mayors and every elected official in this city.
That's what the Ford brothers have said for weeks, that they're victims of a conspiracy and still have the support of voters. People like this Ford loyalist, who believes the mayor's political achievements compensate for his personal challenges.
He didn't run on sort of moral claims. He ran on fiscal claims. And the promises he made have been fulfilled. He's been extremely fiscally responsible, sort of nearly as much to the same extent that he's been morally or personally irresponsible.
It's hard to say just how popular Rob Ford still is after weeks of sometimes sordid information emerges about him. At this Canadian football game in the weekend, he was mobbed by supporters. He's now a staple of comedy routines and has been all over U.S. and Canadian media as a news story and a figure of fun.
Rob Ford has become a bit of a celebrity. I think there's a degree of cult of personality around the man. He's been a far more effective vessel for people's kind of identities than he has actually been a governing mayor.
People gathered at City Hall to watch their council on a big screen in the main rotunda. News of the vote, when it came, made this crowd's political feelings obvious. So now, after this series of votes, City Council has left Rob Ford as mayor, but with very few of the powers of office. But there are legal challenges ahead, possibly more revelations about the mayor's private life, and his own vow to stay on and fight, no matter what. Daniel Lack, Al Jazeera, Toronto.